in today's video, I'm going to be showing you a very cool trick that you can actually use to export videos for free from CapCut without having to worry about the paywall thing. You know, CapCut over the years has been one of the best tools when it comes to lightweight editing. But since we are now being faced with a paywall thing, a lot of us have decided not to update our CapCut anymore, you know, trying to avoid the CapCut. Like somebody like me, the last time I did update my CapCut was since January 2024 and until a few days ago that I had to update to the latest one. Like if I show you, I'm currently using the latest CapCut. And this is because of the cool trick that I'm going to be showing you in this video. Like to do this trick, you don't need any hack, you don't need any crack, you don't need any external software, you don't even need a pro account to use this cool trick. All you need to do is to just watch this video till the end, and I bet you you'd be very happy you did watch this video, because you're going to be learning cool stuff that you wish you had known a very long time ago. All right, without any further ado, let's get straight into it. So the first thing you got to do is finally hit the update button. Because if you're using the old CapCut, honestly, you're missing out on a lot of things. I mean, the new CapCut has a lot of cool features that if you're still in the old one, then you're just missing out. And I can assure you that, because a few days when I updated my CapCut, oh my goodness, CapCut has done a very good and like impressive improvement. So go ahead and update, because after this video, you'd be very happy you did. All right, without any wasting time anymore, so let's get straight into it. So the next thing we're gonna do is to fire on a brand new shiny CapCut. I mean, come on. So once we've done that, the next thing we're gonna do is to drag in some projects. I'm gonna drag in this video of this donkey talking in front of the mic. So I'm gonna try to add some pro features so that we can hit the paywall. So let me go to effect and I'm gonna select some pro features. And let me just select this one and select this one. I'm also going to be adding some pro features from the side. So clicking this one, clicking this one. All right, so let me just throw in an audio. It's not necessary, but let me just throw it in. All right, so we're done and it's time to export our project. So when I click on export and bam, you're using some pro, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. All right, so what are we going to do to avoid this thing from popping up in our face? Because it's terribly annoying. Even though CapCut is making money with it, but I mean, we like free stuff, so we don't want to be seeing it. So what we're going to do to avoid this paywall is to first of all highlight all the projects, like highlight all the work, and then we're going to turn them into a compound clip. So I'm going to select create compound clip. Now that it's created compound clip, so the next step is I'm going to select what is called pre-process. So there's the pre-process option here. Now, if you're using a very slow laptop like I am, this thing is going to take a lot of time. Now, the bigger the project, the longer the time it will take. But come on, we're trying to get a free stuff here. So, I mean, who cares how long it takes? Just go ahead and take all the time you need. Take all the time you need. I mean, take all the time you need, baby. I'm going to wait for you until you're done. So once it's done processing, the next thing we're going to do is, if you're using Mac, just click on the Spotlight search. Now, if you're using Windows, I'm going to show you how you can do it on Windows before the end of this video. But for now, my Mac people, let's continue. So when you click on Spotlight search, you're simply going to enter what is called user data. Just search user data and it comes out. So you select user data. So once you're in user data, you look for the folder called projects. So you're going to select project and then you select the one that is called this one that has the draft at the end. There are three folders you're going to see there, but you're going to select the one that have the draft at the end. And once you're here, you're going to look for the folder that has the name of your project. So in my case, this is the folder that has the name of my project. So I'm going to select it. And then once you've selected it, you look for another folder that is called resources. So when you select the folder that is called resources, you're going to see three folders. Now select the one that is called combination. So you select the combination folder. Now you're going to see two videos in this folder. One has the extension of mp4alpha.mp4. That's not the one we need. We need the one that has just .mp4. So once you see this one, the one that has the .mp4, you're simply going to drag it back into your CapCut project. First thing, don't just drag it on the timeline of the project. First of all, drag it into the project and then drag it in the timeline, but drag it on top of the current project. Just drag it on top of it. And now it's going to ask you if you want to replace clip. Well, select replace clip. So once you've selected the replace clip, the next thing it's going to do is it's going to replace the old video with the new one. And then once it's done that, well, ta-da, free time. So you can now click on export and boom, you can see we're now exporting our videos for free. Now I'm going to wait for it to export and I'm going to show you the finished project. And voila, this is our finished project. We used all the Pro Tools and CapCut and we have it for free on our system. So I know you like what you just saw. So like I said, if you're still using the old CapCut, well, good news. This is the time to upgrade because now you can actually use any of the version and still get what you want for free. I don't know, maybe CapCut sees this video and maybe try to fix this patch or issue or problem or whatever it may be called. But if they try to fix it, well, we will not update again. All right, so now for the Windows users, if you want to repeat the same thing, although it's almost the same process, but if you find it really confusing, there's a link in the description where you can actually watch the full videos on how you can actually do it on your Windows. It's the same thing, it's the same process, but you know, Windows and Mac are not the same thing. So there's a link in the description, you can click on it and you can watch the whole video on how you can actually do it on Windows. Now we've come to the end of this video. If you find this video really helpful, well, hit the like button. And if you've not subscribed to the channel yet, then go ahead and hit the subscribe button, because I will be finding more cool tricks like this and I will be teaching them on this channel. But until next one, peace.